President of Schools, Dr. Margaret Adams, our Assistant Superintendent, Katie Roberts, our Business Director, Aisha Opong, Assistant Principals, Nicole Nosek and Nicole Piantes, and many members of our faculty, representing not only HHS, but also the other schools across the district. So it's pretty cold out here. Seniors, what do you think? Should we go back inside? No. Over the past few days, as the weather forecast worsened, I asked many of our seniors whether we should admit defeat and move the graduation ceremony indoors. I always got the same answer, a resounding no, from everybody. Not just those lucky few who attended the Taylor Swift concert 2 weeks ago tonight, the ones who already had plenty of evidence that a great time can be had in the rain. No, everybody now seated on the field gave a version of the same answer. And it was rooted in their love for the people who are currently seated up in those wet bleachers. They wanted every single one of you to share this moment with them. If these seniors were given a choice, and in a real way they were not willing to leave a single one of you back home. 2 nights ago, as we celebrated the senior prom on a perfect summer-like evening, I asked many of these seniors what we should do in the face of cold drizzle, and they gave no thought to their own comfort. One student told me about a sister who had just flown in from California. Another told me about her grandmother who had just arrived all the way from Ireland. I assume both of these people are up there right now, probably shivering, perhaps clutching an umbrella, but warm inside, filled with pride and love for the sibling or the grandchild about to receive their high school diploma. So I hope all of you agree that we made the right choice by going outside today, even if it's damp and cold. And the real credit belongs to everyone wearing a red gown on the field right now. A little rain cannot deter a truly momentous occasion. And if you want proof, you could get it from one of our great teachers, Mr. Piantes, who insists that the best barbecue he ever hosted was held in the pouring rain. Mr. Piantes also told me yesterday that in Greece, rain on your wedding day is considered a sign of good luck. May the same be true on your graduation day. Like his students, Mr. Piantes expressed support for the outdoor ceremony, but only if we promise to keep the speeches short. So I will oblige. I wrote the first draft of this speech last weekend when we were still expecting sunshine. Now that it's 30 degrees cooler, I'm going to condense the next few pages into two paragraphs. And so here's the executive summary. Across the country, this year's graduating seniors can all lay claim to a unique high school experience. Their ninth grade year was cut short by the pandemic, and their sophomore year was highly unorthodox due to hybrid learning and masking that continued through more than half of their junior year. Here at HHS, though, these 318 seniors have since made up for lost time, and our school is now a better place because of them. The class of 2023 made a large and very positive impact on HHS, especially in terms of revitalizing our school spirit. Individually, they can take great pride in their accomplishments thus far, and collectively, they have established a well-earned reputation for unity, hard work, spirit, perseverance, resilience, and service. The class of 2023 provided essential leadership as our school made its way back, reclaiming cherished traditions and creating new ones. In doing so, they have advanced the mission of our school and reaffirmed its highest values. Class of 2023, as you gather this one last time, look at the teachers assembled behind the podium. Look around you at the classmates who have been loyal friends and steadfast companions. Look into the bleachers, where you will find the people who love you most deeply. Whether they traveled thousands of miles or walked from across the street to get here today, they're all counting on you to help move us closer to the kind of genuine community we all want. And you personify the hope that we can get there one day. You've braved some difficult weather through the past 4 years, and you're doing it again this morning. Keep doing it forever. Thank you very much. And now please welcome our superintendent of schools, Dr. Margaret Adams.
Good morning to our families and our graduates, the class of 2023. Last year, at this time, I was also the proud mom of a high school graduate, and I was so full of pride and love. And to be honest, I shed quite a few tears of joy to see my oldest walk across the stage. And to the families, I know how proud you are today, as it marks yet another milestone for our children. As they move from young adults to adults, growing in their accomplishments and independence. To the graduates, you are so deeply loved and cared for today. Your moms, your dads, your caregivers, grandparents, aunts and uncles, sisters and brothers, they are so proud of all you've accomplished the last 4 years. That ends with walking across the stage today. And I am confident that they will shed tears of joy for you today. You have also been deeply loved and cared by the many educators that have supported you the past 4 years, and they are smiling from ear to ear with pride for you today. You have been cared and loved by each other. Your friends and your peers, they're cheering for themselves, but they're also cheering for you too. They've walked the same path through the halls of the high school with you for the past 4 years. And the community of Hingham stands behind you too. They have strong hopes in all that you will accomplish in the future. To the graduates of the high school, Hingham High School class of 2023, I wish for you, as you move on to new adventures this fall, whether it be a new college campus, a job, the military, or an apprenticeship, to take all of that love, that care, the pride, the joy from today, and share it with all of your new communities on these new adventures. Take all that you've learned for 4 years from your families, your teachers, and your friends. Remember some of the content that you've learned, but most importantly, remember the life lessons that you've learned these past 4 years. Some of these life lessons might include care and love deeply for each other, listen to the voices of others more than you talk, extend a hand to others in need, smile more than you frown. Wish good morning to as many people as you can every day. Sing in the shower. Dance whenever you can. Turn that music up and dance, especially when you're alone. Laugh a lot. Work hard, but remember to have fun. Find a passion and follow it. Rain or shine, the sky is your limit. We can't wait to see all that you accomplish. Congratulations to the families, and especially to you, our graduates. We honor you today. We celebrate you today. Thank you.
And now the chair of our school committee, Ness Carenti.
Thank you so much, Mr. Swanson. Good morning, everyone. I am Ness Carenti,
I'm a member and the chair of the Hingham School Committee. I volunteer to represent you and Hingham residents in shaping the district-wide policies and budgets that impact Hingham Public Schools. If you were to ask me as a high school graduate who the chair of our school committee was and what he or she spoke about in her speech, my response will be the same as yours will be in a few hours. I have no idea, yet here I am. As I was considering what to share with you, I came upon Taylor Swift's commencement speech to New York University's class of 2022. Ironically, I found it on the same day I brought my daughter to Taylor's concert a couple weeks ago. I have no problem admitting to you I'm a proud Swiftie. Who doesn't shimmy a little when hearing Shake It Off? I do more than shimmy. I break into a full-on dance. Those who know me know I love to sing and dance. When I'm feeling down or unmotivated, singing and dancing makes me smile and helps me feel free. And when I'm happy, singing and dancing brings me to a whole other level. Now I know I'm a terrible singer, but I like to think that I'm a pretty good dancer. My kids may think otherwise, but I'll keep dancing like nobody's watching. Another reason why I'm a proud Swiftie is because Taylor has mastered one of life's most important lessons, laughing at yourself, especially at your mistakes. She embraces her goofiness, or as you say, her cringe, and she wears it like the cruel jeweled crown she should wear. In Taylor's speech to NYU, she talked about growing up as a teenager and young adult in the public eye and feeling the pressure that the whole world expected her to be the perfect person and the perfect role model. In her words, "If I slipped up, the entire earth would fall off its axis and it would be entirely my fault and I would go to pop star jail forever and ever." It was all centered around the idea that mistakes equal failure and ultimately the loss of any chance at a happy or rewarding life. Taylor went on to share, "This has not been my experience. My experience has been that my mistakes led to the best things in my life. And being embarrassed when you mess up is part of the human experience. Getting back up, dusting yourself off, and seeing who still wants to hang out with you afterwards and laugh about it, that's a gift." Taylor's right, you know. Of course she's right. She's Queen Taylor Swift. With all seriousness and great sincerity, you are supposed to make mistakes in life. In fact, you must make mistakes during your journey to adulthood and beyond. At some point, each one of you will fail. Will the world fall off its axis? No. Will it feel like it fell off its axis? Perhaps for a little while. But if you allow yourself a moment to pause, look at the people surrounding you and supporting you in that moment, take it in, consider the lesson the mistake was trying to teach you, then find the gift that Taylor described. Seek out the humor in the mistake, or at the very least, try to. Then be sure to laugh at yourself. I hope it's a long laugh, the kind of laugh that eventually brings happy tears to your eyes and makes you want to dance, or even just a shimmy. Finally, graduates, I will leave you with good advice from the Queen herself. Although I would never do her vocals justice, I'll spare you. Because the player's going to play, and the hater's going to hate. Baby, I'm just going to shake. Shake it off. Congratulations, class of 2023. Welcome to the world. It's been waiting for you.
To deliver the address of the salutatorian, Grace Desai.
Good morning, everyone. My name is Grace Desai, and I'm honored to speak to you today as the salutatorian of this year's graduating class. I would like to begin by extending my sincerest congratulations to all of you who sit before me today. This moment is the culmination of all of the work, time, and dedication you have put into your academic careers, and you all have so much to be proud of. Thank you to all of the esteemed faculty, wonderful staff, and loving family members whose support today and throughout our high school careers has been instrumental in getting us to this point. Over the past few weeks, I have been thinking about what advice or words of wisdom I could possibly have for our class as we move on to the next phase of our lives. Although I am largely unqualified to speak on what is to come in the future, I have narrowed my years in Hingham into 5 lessons I have learned and would like to share with you today, hoping they may indeed help you as they helped me. First, do not allow the fear of failure to halt your pursuit of success. Undoubtedly, all of us have faced adversity throughout our years at Hingham, whether that be through the likes of a test, presentation, a global pandemic, or simply the demands of everyday life. With confidence, I can say that you will inevitably make a mistake. You will stumble over your words, say the wrong thing, and not speak when you should have. Things never go the way we plan them. However, failure is not an indication of defeat, but instead an invitation to grow and an opportunity to prosper. I credit the origin of this lesson to the years we spent in elective art classes. From a young age, I have always been an avid proponent of coloring inside the lines. I would stress myself out unnecessarily about the uniformity of the color scheme or the tiny line outside of the black bolded one, while forgetting to have fun with the process. Learning to color within the lines teaches us to accept limits, to accept the predetermined instead of making your own path. In your futures, do not be afraid to color outside of the lines and accept mistakes instead of condemning them. Register for the classes that intrigue and excite you instead of only the required curriculum. Try an intramural sport that your mind has led yourself to believe you won't be good at, and let yourself make mistakes, but do not allow your mind to get fixated on them. Second, ignore the what-ifs that may sneak into your inner consciousness and instead live in the moment. As we move on from the brick walls of Hingham High School, we are not only leaving behind the people we had the privilege of knowing and this building itself, we are also leaving behind the versions of us that exist in this very moment. Never again will you be the person you are right now, at this age, with this mindset, in this instant. I urge you all to live in the moment, to use the perfume that you have been saving for a special occasion, to compliment that person you may not know well, and to simply recognize that you will never get this moment again. Unfortunately, everything comes to an end. Today, we all officially say goodbye to all that is familiar and comfortable. Although this is bittersweet, I urge you all to find the joy in what was and yearn for the potential in what is to come, in the friends you have yet to make and the moments you have yet to experience. Children carry themselves with a sense of innocent, reckless abandon that falls into decline with age. As an adolescent, the world is not riddled with the weight of what-ifs or the burdens of responsibility, but instead a suspended sense of now what. I have found that there is a lot more life out there waiting to be experienced when you are not limited by your own inhibitions. At a young age, my sister gave my brother and I simple advice. Upon reflection, she wished that she had done more while she had both the opportunity and the facilities at her disposal. Talked to more people, played more sports, joined more clubs, made more memories. This advice has carried me throughout my academic career at Hingham High School, to take advantage of my resources and do everything I can to help others do the same. Third, cherish your relationships and the people who you let into your life. This school has provided me, and I imagine many of you, with the people who I am honored to call my friends. They have all individually and collectively taught me the value in finding your people. You are a portrait of all of the people you have loved and surrounded yourself with. Just look at the people sitting beside you now or sitting in the stands enduring this weather for you. I hear my friends in the way I speak. I see my mother when I look in my eyes in the mirror. I see my old art teacher in my handwriting composed of only of capital letters. If I can offer any advice, it is to please hold on to the people who tell you the truth, even when you do not want to hear it. Hold on to the people who love without restraint, who let you be yourself, who use the money on their school account to buy you chips at lunch, who listen with complete and undivided attention, and who share the notes they spent hours taking the night before, minutes before a test. Hold on to the people you can sit in comfortable silence with. I have found that the simple act of sitting and existing next to another person is healing in itself. There is a certain unwavering heartbeat of human connection woven into silence that has power to repair more than words can. Fourth, find what motivates and sparks your courage of conviction. My father's lectures, as I call them, are written with life lessons, many of which have tethered themselves to my consciousness and I hope may latch onto yours as well. One of which is courage of conviction, or having the confidence to make decisions based on insufficient and imperfect information, but informed by experiences, and fiercely advocating that decision despite criticism. This is a value that is built on one's experiences and life journey and honed over time. We have learned some very important values and principles during our 4 years at HHS that we will each carry forward, not only in our next phase, but throughout our lives. We are a class that will be known for our prioritization of inclusion, diversity, and respect for all through our participation, amplification, and creation of clubs, unified sports, and education programs. May we also learn to have the courage and conviction to advocate for these decisions that are impactful in our professional and personal lives. Fifth and finally, understand that hope is a beautiful aspiration, not mere emotion. The final lesson I have learned is to lead your lives with hope. This seemingly simple idea is what has driven me to work hard every day throughout my life, and especially during my time at Hingham High School. Lead yourselves with strength, with dignity, but most importantly, lead with hope. My late sister, Jacqueline, carried herself in alignment with the notion that hope is beautiful, both inside and out. Growing up, my adolescent mind clung to her wise words, and this was no exception. Attitude is everything. Without hope and the fortitude to believe in a better future, you will not find the success you are looking for. And with all of the potential I can see across the field right now, you owe it to yourselves not to waste it. Thank you all for making this high school such a wonderful and welcoming community. I am humbled and honored to be standing in front of such bright, intelligent, and kind individuals, and I cannot wait to see what each of you do. I wish you all the best of luck in your future endeavors, and once again, congratulations.
Now, please welcome the class valedictorian, Nathan Tesler.
Not opened this one before. How about another round of applause for that amazing speech by Grace Desai? The Hingham crew team was very, very proud that two of its own got valedictorian and salutatorian. I hear your cheers in the audience. The amazing thing about crew is that there is no such thing as personal achievement. It taught me a lot about humility. Some people may say I needed that. In the boat, there are no stars and there are no clutch plays. Gabe Wagner's not out there scoring 1,000 Mick points. Every success and every failure is borne equally by the members of the boat. But even outside the world of crew, no accomplishment is really truly individual. Though I stand here right now as the result of individual achievement, nominally, it is only with the help of a long list of people that my success has been possible. I'm sure the same is true for all of us graduates. And at least for most of us, that help starts at home. I'm going to shout out my mom, my dad, and my brother Gabe. I'll throw in my dog, too. Can we just take a moment to recognize all the parents and family members here today, whether from Ireland or from just down the street, who have helped us reach this point in our journeys. My own journey in the Hingham schools started when I was just 3 years old. Three-year-old me already showed some signs of greatness with unique skills like the ability to identify the make and model of every single car in the, as I called it then, the Derby Chappez parking lot. But I also arrived with an assortment of developmental challenges. I was not always a great student. I was kicked out of preschool, playmates. Thankfully, I got accepted to the integrated preschool at Hingham Schools for the second semester. And since that moment, so many different people in the Hingham schools have played essential parts in my journey, from my preschool teachers who helped me tie my shoes, to my high school teachers who smiled as I set 100-meter records sprinting to the pencil sharpener during tests. I would not be here without any one of them. The list is long, and I won't try to name everyone, but a few who come to mind are my preschool occupational therapist, Ms. Francis, my first grade teacher, Ms. Amster, Mr. Flo, who helped me become the first Hingham student to make it to the state GOB, to the sadly departed Mr. Quine, who realized I had no ability to manage paper, particularly with the middle school rule that you could not carry a backpack between classes. He gave me the right to carry a, as he called it, a satchel. I would be remiss not to acknowledge Miss Bellis and Mr. Cincotta, who provided a refuge during the school day to me and so many others where we could get together and make music. And of course, we all owe a huge thank you to the teachers, administrators, facility staff, school committee, guidance counselors, lunch staff, volunteers, Opry, Taco, and everybody else who keeps the school running. But equally importantly, I want to thank the Hingham class of 2023. When I went back to watch the speeches from last year, both Dom and Matt talked a lot about the resilience of their class. And given that COVID hit them midway through their high school journey, it makes sense that that would be the dominating theme for the class of 22. Obviously, we too needed resilience to make it through those years. But the theme that really defines our class is what comes after. After the difficulty and separateness of COVID, we felt a stronger desire to come together than ever before. We had to rebuild, and we had to do it together. As seniors, we inherited a school and a district in a tough place. We had gone through years of a global pandemic. We'd run three superintendents out of town, and we were facing a huge budget shortfall. Despite the hand that we were dealt, we weren't satisfied with treading water or going at the pace at Union Street at 2:40 p.m. In our sports and extracurriculars, we took programs, damaged by COVID and struggling to hold on and return them to greatness. For example, how amazing is the band? You know what? Give them a round of applause right now. I'll tell you, just two short years ago, we were in our rooms on Zoom playing alone. That does not work. Cannot work, despite Mr. Cincotta's best efforts. When we came back together in a tent on this field in the mud, we stepped up and we showed the underclassmen who only knew Zoom band what high school band actually was. I'm sure it's been similar in other groups. Further, many have pointed to the Red Army as an example of how our class not only brought school spirit back, but took it to a level not seen in recent years. Can we get one more round of applause for the Red Army and their five-star general, Evan Doherty? It's quite loud. Taking the applause, Evan? I do have to say, I had some concerns about the name. I did not think that we should be bringing communism to the South Shore. When I discussed this with President Cal, he told me that the history simply made the name more intimidating. While the Red Army failed at instituting communism on the South Shore, it did, in fact, demonstrate the power of the collective. The Red Army represented more than neon garb and baby powder cannons. It was a demonstration of our mutual support for each other and our commitment to leave the school greater than we found it. We weren't satisfied with simply bringing back a sense of school pride. We had to bring it back greater than ever. We made it inclusive, and we made it for everybody. We made unified sports the heart of our school. The Special Olympics banner in our gym is a visual reminder of our whole school's commitment to inclusivity. We also had to show up big time for our school and our town as we continued to rebuild from the pandemic. Many members of our class turned out to support the override, both at town meeting and at the ballot box. Several at my urging. Some even from actually watching the Friday show. I think it was all worth it. Especially I thank Trevor Buckeridge for his impactful words at town meeting. We did not need to work so hard to support the override. It's wind. But we cared about our legacy. We wanted the classes after us, our friends and siblings, to have the same amazing experience at Hingham that we all had. Of course, there were a few things our class managed to tear down rather than rebuild. Future classes will never get to go to Camp Wing. Perhaps that's for the better. The senior car parade, in the overheard words of Officer Ford, would happen again only on an airstrip. But as Mark Rober just said this past weekend in his commencement at the second best college in Cambridge, MIT, it is good to occasionally participate in playful anarchy. Wherever you go after this, a college, a university, a workplace, time off, or somewhere else, apply the lessons of these years. As you have at Hingham, harness the power of community to leave wherever you go better than it was before. As the South School kids say, be kinder than necessary. Show up for your roommate's game, or your new friend's play, or your high school friend's concert, like Learn to Speak. We have a few more gigs this summer. And remember, it was not just the coming together of your circle. It was all of us, the musicians, the athletes, the fans, the academics, the actors, and the many diverse combinations that make up the class of 2023. As world-famous, critically acclaimed author Monica Tesler said in the fifth book of the Bounder series, in diversity lies the true wealth of a universe. It's truly been my privilege to be on this boat with you. We may be pointed towards our next shore, but the ripples and waves behind us will leave an impact for the rest of our life. To quote almost as famous as Monica Tesler, Taylor Swift, long live all the magic that we made. I remember it all too well. Thank you, class of 2023. And get excited for Susie Anderson.
Not an easy act to follow. But we have a couple of people who probably could live up to that challenge. The first of them is a student speaker chosen by a vote of teachers, administrators, and fellow students, Susie Anderson.
Thanks, Nathan, for that. Good morning. Today is Saturday, June 3rd, and it's day one, Drop G Block. Please stand and join me for the Pledge of Allegiance. I'm just kidding, Nathan. Old habits die hard. This year, I had the pleasure of coming into the main office every day to read the morning announcements. In this role, I learned that with great power comes great responsibility. I also learned that if I mispronounce one single word over the intercom, I will be on the receiving end of a text message from Evan Doherty that reads, "Wake up." But just before I would stumble through the results of a recent track meet over the PA system, I bore witness to the front lines of the welcome to Hingham High School. With each passing face through the main office, I marveled at the efficiency at which Mrs. Black, Mrs. Skinner, or Mrs. Johnson connected students with their counselors, directed visitors to their meetings, or offered to hang out with Opry. I quickly learned that our school community functions as a product of the collaborative efforts of those within it. So as we have since tackled 4 years of high school, the daunting college admissions process, and low points in which the only thing keeping us going was the shrine to Danny DeVito in the big stall of the 280s bathroom, I hope that as a class, we take time to acknowledge those who helped us get here today. Undoubtedly, your individual efforts factor into your success. Only you, as an individual student, could feel the harrowing isolation of being the only blinking circle on a shared Google Doc as you cram an essay the night before it's due. But I ask you to imagine for a moment that glorious sense of relief when a second Google profile pops up on that doc at 1:30 a.m., reassuring you that even in the depths of your academic despair, you are not alone. That single moment of shared Google Doc suffering reinforces the hope found in shared experiences. Although you might not recognize it, the trials and successes you experienced to get here today were not just your own. They were shared with a friend, a parent, a teacher, a coach, a sibling, or even a support dog. Those who you let in for support, inadvertently or not, contribute to creating the person that you are sitting here today. From helping you decide on a future path, to holding the door open as you rush from Farlot, big and small acts from the community around you amounted to new opportunities for success. As Mr. Raymond once said in our English class, when I mentioned, among other intellectual topics, Kylie Jenner, no one is truly self-made. So as we continue forward in our lives, I ask you to remind yourself of those who have helped you along the way. Even when you think you might not need it, a little support can make all the difference. With our senior year coming to an end, it's easy to focus on the lasts. Last football game, last day of school, last Big Daddy's pizza. But the class of 2023 is used to lasts. In fact, we have had lasts since the sixth grade, when we were the last group allowed to sleep over at Camp Wing. But at the same time, Camp Wing definitely marked a first experience for us all. So as we leave here today, instead of dwelling on the lasts, look forward to the many firsts that are yet to come. Congratulations, class of 2023, and have a great day.
Our final speaker this morning is the president of the class of 2023, Cal Larson.
All righty. Hi, everyone. My name is Cal Larson, and I have been the Hingham High class of 2023 president for the past 4 years. There we go. With that being said, today is sadly the last day that I'll be able to milk this title, and I'm going to be taking advantage of that for one final time. I would like to start off by thanking Mr. Swanson, Mrs. Piantes, Ms. Nosek, Officer Ford, and all of my peers who joined me in the 280s bathroom on May 12th. In all seriousness, I would like to apologize to all the custodians that day for the mess that was made. Without all of you guys, the school would not be able to operate, and on behalf of my classmates and I would like to say thank you guys so much for truly everything. Can we get a round of applause for them? Next, I would like to thank Mrs. Dorr and Mrs. Jackson for dealing with a 5'1 freshman who later evolved into a questionable 5'8 senior. The amount of scheduling, emailing, and meetings that were held to help ensure this class's success is truly remarkable, and I will forever be thankful for your guidance. And to my fellow officers throughout the years, Eric Goo, Johnny Heffernan, Riley Frank, Sydney Driscoll-Gannon, and Connor Lash, your companionship and endless hours of help towards completing all of our goals has not gone unnoticed and forever leave a positive impact on this class. Although, I would like to call out Connor Lash as his campaign promise of fixing the school Wi-Fi never happened. Up until the last day of school, I was still unable to send out my morning snap streaks from OC's room. And I could sit here forever and I could thank all those who have been there for me and helped me throughout my run, but I feel like I can hear Connor McCann's stomach from here, and he's getting pretty hungry. And when I was elected class president on that crisp fall afternoon in 2019, I was very unsure of what the future would hold. It was only a few weeks later when I realized our class had a special thing going for us. It was Friday Night Lights. Here we go. And Hingham would be hosting Duxbury. I had quickly been told we'd have the opportunity to sell concessions for this game, so my fellow officers and I jumped on the opportunity. The game was absolutely packed, considering Hingham vs. Duxbury always had a large crowd, and my classmates and I began to thrive off the big audience. We were jammed throughout the night in that concession room, but no one was ever stressed out or even missed a beat throughout the whole game. The many volunteers we had were all working together and were completely in sync. We even had kids going out into the stands to sell the remaining calzones. The ambition and school spirit our class had on this night was prominent, and I believe it foreshadowed all the amazing things we would later bring to the table, like massive fundraising amounts, and of course, the Red Army. I was very happy with how things were going freshman year, as we had success at homecoming, the holiday fair, and even brought a group of kids to the Celtics. And although we were sitting in the nosebleeds, that game was still more enjoyable than the Game 7 massacre that sadly happened last week. That was the last event we had for a little while due to the COVID shutdown, but my thoughts always stayed high when thinking of our class, and I knew we would prevail. Later on, as I was reflecting on my last 4 years, it occurred to me what an honor it is to be in this position. When you are elected to be in a leadership role for a class that accomplishes so many things, you realize how fortunate you really are. The class of 2023 has had so many successes throughout our 4 years that have helped build a very strong reputation. Whether it is the superior senior leadership on our girls' soccer team that led to a Division I state championship, to supporting one of the best shooters in Hingham High basketball history as he sunk the shot for 1,000 career points. The All-Town Concert that was led by our senior musicians and they put on an absolute show. And in an amazing run by the Hingham Drama Program, finishing as semi-finalists at the METG State Festival. Or last, you know, forcing half the grade to buy Red Army t-shirts so you could buy unlimited skillets at the 99. These are only a few of the many amazing things we've accomplished as a class, and I'm more than proud of all you. My final message I will leave with all you is to bring all of your ambition, creativity, and resilience you brought to these amazing 4 years of high school with you, wherever your next journey takes you. I would not trade these last 4 years of my life here at Hingham High for anything in the world, and I hold all of my classmates here very close to my heart. If any of you ever need someone to talk to about literally anything, I will always be here for you guys. And as a wise young man once said in 2019, make sure to keep your stick on the ice. Thank you, everyone, and enjoy the rest of your day.
Now, please welcome members of the HHS Chorus to perform Corner of the Sky.
I think I'm not after anything at all.
Dr. Adams, it gives me great pleasure to certify to you that all those receiving diplomas today have met all the requirements for graduation as established by the Commonwealth of Massachusetts and the Hingham School Committee. Graduates, please come forward to receive your diplomas.
Tell me when you're ready. You good? You good? What'd you say? Yeah. Okay. Ryan Adams. Chelsea Adler. Julian Alessi. Isabella Amade. Lily Andre. Ethan Andruskevich. Madeline Augie. Zara Awada. Andrew Baker. William Baker. Charles Banks. Brian Bernard. Thomas Barnett. Sean Barry. Asher Baines. Morgan Beagley. Lucas Bell. Wyatt Bell. Samuel Benham. Abigail Benyon. Ben Berardi. Angus Bernstein. Elizabeth Beyer. Megan Bianchi. Phineas Bias. Caroline Bilodeau. Elizabeth Blackwood. Clara Bodner. Marielle Bogan. Lydia Borden. Bryce Botello. Isabella Bottini. Aiden Brazzo. Christopher Branzi. Lauren Brockwell. Abigail Brown. Elena Bryden. Trevor Buckridge. Emma Buckley. William Buckley. Owen Burley. Liam Burns. Alden Burt. Ryan Carlton. Christopher Carr. Daniel Carroll. Liam Casey. Joseph Cassidy. Samantha Chapin. Nolan Clark. Lucas Clifford. Anna Clow. Haley Kogel. Mitchell Comer. Andrew Concannon. Griffin Coppola. Aiden Costello. Connor Cummings. Emily Cusano. William Darcy. Lauren Davis. Grace DeSells. Ashley Delmonico. Jude Denning. Catherine D. Bartolomeo. Cameron Dobson. Ellie Dodd. Evan Doherty. Charles Donahue. Ashley Dong. James Donnelly. Ashling Doyle. Brian Doyle. Michael Doyle. Sydney Driscoll. Nicholas Dubois. Alexandria Dumas. John Dwyer. Georgia English. Zoe Epstein. Caitlin Erickson. Eloise Estes. Charles Even. Anthony Fabrizio. James Fabrizio. Thomas Fabrizio. Benjamin Farrington. Ruby Fernandez. Mia Filardi. Nathan Finney. William Florick. Brooke Flynn. Bridget Foley. Caitlin Foley. Abigail Fortune. Francesco Fulcinetti. Nicholas Fulcinetti. Cameron Fuller. Quinn Gainey. Laura Gallagher. Ryan Gates. Nicholas Germain. Emily Gibbons. Matthew Gilman. Julia Glennon. Lauren Grady. Ian Grimm Jr. Ella Griswold. Jennifer Gross. Theo Grossman. Can you hear me? Patrick Haberlin. Mia Haggerty. Olivia Halley. Colette Haney. Bridget Harrington. Catherine Harrington. Samantha Harris. Alexander Hart. Colin Hoy. Kai Hawes. Joseph Hennessy. Brendan Hill. Eliana Hobson. Sinead Hogan. Sarah Holler. Anders Holmquist. Maria Hull. Hunter Jack. Alexander Jacob. Emma Jacob. William Jacobus. Kate Jagelski. Evan Jewell. Zachary Johnson. Elise Jones. Piper Jordan. Natalie Cardus. Stephen Kelleher. Nicholas Ken. Abigail Kennedy. Alexandra Kennedy. Thomas Kennedy. Lindsay Kennaway. Daniel Kent. Ava Knight. Jack Kososki. Julia Kososki. Nicholas Kraus. Ethan Kulin. Luke Kylander.
Benjamin Lorette. Connor Lash. Lucy Lasher. Olaf Laurel. Cameron Lawler. Jasper Lee. Liam Lennon. Joshua Loeb McDonough. Margaret Lowther. Lana Marie Lucas.
Congratulations, Sam.
Nora Lundeen. Jack Lyons. James McDonald. Mark McClellan. Michael Magner. Cade Marsden. Lou Martell. Liam McBride. Catherine McCann. Connor McCann. Caroline McCarthy. Christian McCluskey. Patrick McGonigal. Alexander McGowan. Maxwell McKelvey. Chase McKenna. Luke McClellan. Jackson McManus. Chloe McNabb. Jillian McNamara. Madeline McPhillips. Mathilde Maygard. Jace Mellish. Riley Mellish. Colin Minucci. Emma Mills. Celia Monarch. Chanel Morris. Samuel Morris. Sophia Morrissey. Maxfield Moyer. Ava Mulcaren. Grace Mullen. Megan Munoz. Shane Murphy. Connor Murray.
Brenna? Didn't say it. Did she walk?
Brenna Moynihan.
Thank you. All right, where are we?
Connor Murray.
Skip Brenna.
Cooper Murray.
I'm tied up. So sorry.
Jack Murtaugh. Marie Nidecker. Sadie Nidecker. Joao Ehiki Neto. Matthews Neves. Vivian Nguyen. Olivia Nimborker. Maximilian Noring. Audrey Nolan. Daniel Norgard. Clara Novak. Kendra O'Brien. Ronan O'Cardevon. Rachel O'Connor. Kyla Odell. Julia O'Dwyer. Hang in there. Brendan O'Horo. Margaret O'Keefe. Samuel Opedizano. Sarah O'Reilly. Finn Osterberg. Adam Overton-Hagee. Olivia Pace. Charles Packard. Aaron Packard. Vladimir Polchikov. Sydney Polisi. Josephine Papone. Samuel Peacock. Robert Pierce.
Thank you. I'm like worried about this. Oh my God. All right, where are we? I don't know where I left off.
Robert Pierce.
I got you. All right, sorry.
Leonie Pena.
Oh my God. Thank you. Ripping.
Peter Peterson. Talia Petrillo. Christiana Phillips. Jack Pilot. Annabelle Platt.
I don't want to miss up.
Brendan Prestia. Allison Kwan. Sean Quinn. Catherine Radulski. Joshua Ragusa. Benjamin Rakowskis.
Oh,
Sophie Real. Thomas Reardon. Sean Reagan. Riley Raposa.
I'm like yelling. Oh my God.
Connor Richardson. Jake Robbins. Edward Rockte. Charles Rogan.
Oh my God.
Connor Rooney. Bennett Ross. Noah Ross. James Rosanitas. Arthur Rubel. Joseph Rubino. Christopher Rooley. Claire Ryan. Teresa Ryan. Cole Sampson. Victor San Antonio. Ellen Savickas. Caroline Schiffman. Brad Shortman. Jake Schulte. James Michael Schwartz. Joseph Andrew Schwartz. Celeste Cito. Marco Scobo. Nathan Shane. Riley Sheehan. Skylar Schickel. Sean Shubin. Theodore Smith. Angelina Salamini. Ella Statlander. Angelina Stone. Isabella Stone. Aiden Stewart.
Oh my God, Tia Zotley.
Sophia Suarez. Isabella Sullivan. Catherine Sweeney. Sherry Z. Caitlin Aska Tyra. Frank Tambro the Fourth. Kelsey Tarby. Freya Tenebo. Jake Thompson. Whitley Thompson. Luke Thrun. Catherine Tyne. Asia Tony James. Aiden Toole. Bayan Triba. Connor Trainer. Catherine Van Buskirk. Michaela Vaness. Elena Vasilekos. Christopher Venancio. Gabriel Wagner. Michael Wagner. Madison Whitehouse. Dylan Whiting. Jack Whitney. Colin Wilner. Henry Woodyatt. Jacob Yates. Joshua Zyper. Grace Desai. Nathan Tesler. Susan Anderson. Lily Ehler. Michael Renna. Mitra Sophie Mogtetter. Cecilia Mann. Carrie Breen. John Heffernan. Caroline Frank. Eric Gu. And Calvin Larson. Kel's gonna close this out.